Welcome back. In the last video, we did an overview on saved searches. In this lesson, I'd like to go into some of the key parameters for saved searches and give you an example of an actual use case for one. So let's take a look at this. Okay, so here we're on the home page. So let's go to reports, and then we're going to go down to new search. And like I mentioned in the last video, the bread and butter of saved searches really is transactions. So let's just go down to transactions and let's make this type of search a transaction search. Okay, so let's just break down what you see here. We've got criteria on the left and we've got results on the right. So those are definitely the two most important parameters. And the concept is criteria is really the filter. It's adjudicating what are the things that we're searching for. The example I gave in the last lesson is all sales orders over $500. So in that case, you would be searching criteria, all sales orders over the value of $500. Now on the flip side, you've got results. So that's saying, okay, now that we've located all sales orders over $500, what information do we want? What do we want to see from that? We want to see, in that example, it was the type of customer, where that customer lives, and also the type of items that are composing those sales orders. So those would all be things that we would list in the results section. So we would be gathering from the criteria and we'd have the output on the results side. So if we look down here, you can specify, you can add in criteria, and then you can add in results. Now, because we did a transaction kind of preset, it actually gives us all of these it guesses what you would probably want in results for a transaction. But honestly, I don't need all this information. So I'm just gonna say remove all. We're gonna do a specific search here. So I'm gonna remove that. So we're starting at square zero. And so let's mock something up here. In this search, let's say you ran an e-commerce business and you wanted to know, all right, you've got sales orders going, but there's a certain point where the sales order goes over to fulfillment, which is composed of picking the items, packing them for shipment, and then actually shipping them out. But you've noticed that there's some issues or problems resulting from shipments not going out. So you wanna do a saved search that's giving you a bit of information about what items are actually on that fulfillment line and have either been picked or packed, but not yet shipped. So you can do a saved search that would show all of those things specifically. So I'm gonna run you through how you would build this saved search for this particular scenario. So first off, we would go to filter, and there's a number of parameters we're gonna enter to fit this scenario. First off, we're gonna add mainline. Now mainline is a very common parameter that you set for, I'm not gonna say all saved searches, but it's very, very common. And the reason for that is that you're basically specifying with mainline, you're saying whether you want the type of thing to be almost like a header level concept. So for example, if we're talking about sales orders, mainline would be the sales order itself, all right? So sales order 259, that is a mainline item. Now, if that sales order has, let's say, a washing machine, a blender, and a microwave, those little items are all called line level items, right? The microwave, it's the washing machine. So mainline would be the sales order, line level would be all the items that compose that sales order. So in this case, we don't really care about all the things that are involved in the sales order. We just wanna know which ones are shipping or not shipping. So we want mainline. So I'm gonna select mainline, yes. We don't want all the items, we just want that summation of them in the fact of the sales order itself. If we didn't want that and we did want to see all the things being composed of these sales, and we didn't want to see the summary, which is the sales order is the full amount, then we would click no and we would just get all those individual items that make up every sales order you have. So we've decided on yes, so let's click set. Okay, next up, I'm going to put in type. Now, again, a very common parameter you're gonna set for a lot of saved searches, and that's simply saying, well, what kind of thing are we even talking about? We know we want mainline, but what are we talking about? Are we talking about customers? Are we talking about sales orders in this case? Now, while it is sales orders, we're a little more specific here. We're gonna be looking for item fulfillments. So we have item fulfillment here, and I'm gonna hit set. Okay, good. So we have item fulfillment, but it's not just any item fulfillment. We want to know specifically it's at a point where it hasn't necessarily been shipped yet. So let's do status. So let's go down to, and it says any of, right? So anything that fits, and you can select multiple lines here. So we're gonna go down to item. Okay, so we want anything that's picked or packed, but we're not gonna click shipped. So let's say set. And when I'm clicking them, I'm holding control, so it's selecting multiple items at once. Okay, so we have mainline, we have type, we have status. Okay, so next we're gonna specify a certain time period. Let's say you just wanna know everything that hasn't shipped in the last month. So you would put in date. And it's gonna give you all these options. You can go up here and it'll get all these different kind of parameters within date. We're just gonna say within, so within that time period. And then you can specify kind of calendar from here to here, but we've got these presets over here. So why don't we just go to month and specify that we want it this month. So really just in this past 30-day time period. So let's set that. And now we've got all of our criteria. So now we're gonna jump over and take a look at our results. And we're gonna skip this top part for now, and we're just gonna go to field. We're gonna take a look at transaction number. And really, that's simply the number that when the sales order gets to the fulfillment stage, it's actually given its own number to make it unique to that fulfillment stage. And the transaction number is gonna be that number. So we wanna see what is that fulfillment item that is locked up in the fulfillment process, but not yet shipped. So we wanna search transaction number. So we're gonna add that. We're also gonna add, well, we wanna know what's the name of the customer that this is fitting, right? Who are the customers that are being affected by items not being shipped? So if we put name, that will give us our customer name. We also wanna put in created from. And what that's gonna tell us is, okay, so you have this item fulfillment number, but what sales order is that coming from? And created from will give us that. So let's put in created from. We also wanna know the date. At what point has that sales order been created? So we can see how close is it to being, you know, in that 30-day window. And lastly, we're gonna take a look at status. So just like in our criteria, we wanna get items that are just at the fulfillment stage, either picked or packed, but not shipped. But we do wanna see, are they picked or are they packed? Which of the two? So we can add status, which will give us that information. So now that we have all of this set out, we know what we want for the criteria, we know what we want for results, we're gonna hit submit, which will run this search. Okay, so here we have the results. We see three items came up, and we can see, again, that transaction number that we set, so what was that item fulfillment number, and then we can see the customer or the client name that was resulting from that. And we can see the sales order that was associated with that item fulfillment. We can see the date of that sales order and the stage or status that it's at. So we have a packed and we have two that are picked. So great, we have this saved search that we made. It's got three items that came up, but it's not actually yet a saved search. So let's actually go up to here and we can hit save this search. So that's gonna bring us to this other kind of page here. And as you'll see, it's really a little bit more of an advanced version of what we had before, right? We still have criteria over here, we still have results, but now we have all of these other items in the sub-tab. We also have this information up above. So I'm not gonna get into the other sub-tab items until the next videos, but I'm gonna cover a couple of these items up here. So first off, really what these buttons are specifying is you're gonna make this save search. Now, how are you going to access it, or how are other people going to access it? So for example, do you want it available on the dashboard, which I'm going to show you in another video how you would add it to your dashboard. But let's say we want that as an option, so we're going to click that. We also want it available in the reminders portlet. In the home dashboard module, I covered the reminders portlet and how you would add things on there. So I want that as an option there. So I'd click reminders and show in menu. That means that when we go to this menu here and we go down to save searches, we want it to be one of these automatically included save searches. So I do want that. So I'm gonna say show in menu. And then lastly, I'm gonna click on public, and that's gonna make it available to others. It's not just gonna be to me. And there's kind of other parameters you can set in terms of who can see it, but this is just giving that blanket, you know, others are able to see that. So let's click on that. And we also want to make sure we give an appropriate title. So let's say item fulfillment pending but not shipped. So that is the category of this save search. And we go to the bottom and we're gonna hit save and run. Now you can also go over here and click preview. That will show you the save search without actually saving it. That can be a little dangerous though, because if you click on it and it's perfect and you're like, this is great, and then you move on from there, it's easy to forget that you didn't actually save that search and then everything you've just done is lost. So you do wanna make sure that if you click on preview and you like it, you go back and actually save the search. So in this case, we're fine with it. We're gonna just hit save and run. All right, so we now have this as a saved search. Again, it's that same search we saw before, but it is now available. And if we go back to our homepage here, all right, so here we are in the home dashboard. So if we go back to reports, save searches, we can actually see it right here in item fulfillment, pending but not shipped. So it's available in the menu, it's also available on the dashboard, and we can add it to the reminders. So that's it on how to do a save search. In the next videos, we're gonna be covering more detail on save searches and some of the additional customization features for them. So I'll see you there.